Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm your bubbly blonde, fabulously dressed.
In the Hamptons, and I'm here with Rita Crosby, and she looks fabulous as usual.
Thank you.
Tell me about how you got invited to this event.
You know what? To me, I love what Social Life does. I have such respect, of course, for the owner and the publisher, and this is the place to be in the Hamptons, especially on such a beautiful summer night.
Yes, it is beautiful.
It's really incredible, and also they do a lot of charitable things, which is great, about giving back and about remembering what it's all about, and I really applaud them. I'm so happy to be here, and also just love to me. Earlier in the day, I was at Jill Zarin's event.
Tell me about that. I missed that event. I went to
You missed a good one.
I went to the black and white gala in Shelter Island.
I see with your beautiful black and white. Jill Zarin's luxury luncheon. She has the most amazing event, and a lot of the proceeds go to the Samuel Waxman Foundation, so go to a great cause. Jill is so incredible. She knows how to put on the most amazing party. It was tons of women this year. She had a man cave, so she had a great like area for the guys as well, and all these incredible like vendors with new products. All the who's who of the Hamptons were all there. All the Real Housewives were there, and Jill is like the consummate party putter on her. She puts on a party like nobody's business, and that was unbelievable.
I want to know, was Ramona Singer there?
Ramona was there, and I saw...
Wow! Ramona was there!
Cynthia Bailey? Cynthia Bailey was there?
No, Ramona and her don't talk, so that's a big thing.
Oh, that's interesting. Oh, yeah, Ramona was there. Ramona was there. In fact, I didn't see Ramona.
So they made up.
I'll find out the scoop.
They kissed and made up.
I'll find out the scoop. They obviously did. She was there, and Cynthia Bailey was there. Contessa was there. There were a lot of them that were there.
The Countess.
Yes, the Countess.
She's friends with Luann.
Yes, but Ramona was there.
Oh, my God.
It was a happy, beautiful weather, and how could you be mad at Jill Zarin? Jill Zarin's a great gal. So
I love Jill.
I'm glad that things have resolved, because she's a fabulous woman.
I love her. I do too. Yeah, so you look fetching in leopard.
Thank you. You know what? I figured when you're with somebody like this, you got to dress up and you got to look the part. You got to try to hold your own when you're with a fashionista like this. But I love being in the Hamptons. I love being here at a special event. And I love your heart, because you always do so many great things and you get the word out about all the great celebrity events.
The whole thing is not that we're interviewing celebrities. The whole thing is this particular event is going to benefit the Bridgehampton Historical Society.
Yes, which is why I'm here and why I care about it.
Yes, we want everybody to know that. It's not just about celebrities. It's about benefiting all the historical societies here on the East End. And you're a big supporter, and thank you for talking to me. Where are you up to? Where are you going now?
Well, I'm going back to the city because on my show tomorrow, I have Donald Trump on my show tomorrow. So, and I've got John Kasich, who's also... going to be announcing in a few days that looks like that he's running for president. I've been covering all the presidential races, so it's kind of nice to have a little bit of a breather for such a great cause. Like,
will you vote? Would you vote for Donald?
You know what? I have never told anybody who I vote for. I am truly independent, and I have never told anybody, even my wonderful significant other doesn't know who I voted for. It's top secret, top secret. But all the candidates are also interesting this go around. I mean, you look at that. On the Democratic side, it's certainly interesting.
He's definitely a very exciting individual.
Definitely
and
not
he
boring.
Does get things done.
He does, and he's a great businessman.
I mean, if he's a president and our president and he wants to get a law passed, I think he could do it.
But, and I think he's extremely patriotic. He's extremely dedicated to this country, as I think everybody running for president is, quite frankly, whether you're talking about on the Republican or the Democratic side, because, I mean, you have to be, because it's a tough slog to get there, to get the nomination, whatever it's Republican on Democratic side. And we'll see. It's going to be certainly a really fun time to cover the presidential race. It's fascinating on both the Republican and the Democratic side.
Well, thank you so much, Rita, for talking to me right here at St. Barts in the Hamptons. You are always a joy to talk to. You have always interesting subjects to talk about. And I thank you very much. And as we say in show business, break a leg and you look gorgeous.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. She's fabulous. We love her. And we love Social Life for helping those stories.
And we'll be back in a moment, guys. More interviews right here in the Hamptons. Keep watching. Pete Champagne Kisses.
Fun people, fun crowd, good energy, great music, great food.
I think that's why my husband likes it too. A lot of sexy girls.
That also.
Now you have a very, very important event every year in the Hamptons, right here. Tell my audience, what is your event all about?
Well, first, I raise a lot of money for my charity. It's called the Peaceman Foundation. And then I reward them and thank them by inviting them to my big party, my big record release party at the end of the summer. I wrote an anti-bullying anthem called Kiss All the Bullies Goodbye. It's produced by Paul Oakenfold, and it features the vocals of Taylor Dane. And I also gave $100,000 away to 10 different anti-bullying charities, and all the proceeds from the song, the video, the downloads are all going to those 10 anti-bullying charities. So on Saturday, August 22nd, I'm going to show the Hamptons something they've never seen before. I'm going to turn it back in time into the ambiance and the vibe of Studio 54. And I'm rechristening my castle, calling it Studio 54. And you're going to have to come dressed as one of the village people. And I have 20 of the world's greatest hustle and Latin hustle dancers on the planet from Stepping Out Studios, one of the best dance studios in the world. And we're going to celebrate the LGBT community, the straight community, mixed together the way it should be.
Tell my audience why you think the Hamptons is so special.
The Hamptons, great weather.
Great weather. What else?
A lot of things to do.
If we want to find out more about you, Ivan, where can we go? What's your website?
SirIvan.com.
SirIvan.com. Well, you are the best, and thank you for that interview. And we'll be back in a moment, dollies. More interviews right here at St. Barts in the Hamptons. Keep watching. Be champagne kisses.
It's been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.